We have representation. Rahul is here with us as well also. You know, it's very interesting when, to do something like this, because it's not the traditional art gallery where you have people coming in, you know, looking at the art and then trying to understand what it's all about. What I wanted to do was to, you know, exhibit the artists along with their art. You have visions, you have ideologies, you have thoughts behind the art that you create. I want to generally to talk to you about what goes behind the process. We will start with Rahul, since Pooja is not here as well also. Do tell us a bit about when you watch Pooja create her art, where do you see her thought process going? As a layman, as a non-artist.
She gets all these ideas from TV, from talking to people, and when she zeroes in on something, then she gets caught, like she's just laying on her bed, and she doesn't come out, and she's there 4 a.m., 5 a.m., and out of reach, out of contact, one, sorry, bye. So that's how it goes, it's like just concentrate on work. She does it pretty well because she also has a job, and you know, so it's pretty tough, I think, handling it, but she does it pretty well. Switch off.
A lot of the work, as I read it, and she mentioned, it's commission based. So a lot of it is very unique and it's very individual pieces, so they never replicate it.
How long has she been doing this? But very recently, you know, she showed her art with people. So I think in the beginning, someone asked me for a portrait. I don't know which one it was. But she did a really, she just changed it. Like it looked like the same thing, but yet not the same thing, you know. So after that happened, then it just opened up for like lots of people started calling her. Lots of different ideas, lots of different portraits. Lots of different series of paintings she's done, these rock stars, and she has a few color series. It's, you know, varied over a period of time.
She's always a man. Because otherwise, you never finish. That's the point of time. Rahul, when you watch Pooja work, and you mention that she's up till 4 5 in the morning, and not coming out of her room, and not, you know, looking at you, what she's creating. What do you feel? When should, from a non-artist perspective, when should an artist generally stand back and say, okay, I'm done with this painting? Not that the painting is done. You always have to be done, or whatever, otherwise you'll never walk away from it. What do you feel?
There's lots of times
when
she, you know, says,
let me
check it out, and this is okay, you know? So, she
sometimes, in the beginning, I used to say, like, oh, this is, like, you know, something here. And then I stopped doing that because, you know, she obsesses about it. And I say, like, you know, I think something's wrong here. Then like, for days and days, oh, what's it, this, that, you know, I have to change this, I have to change that. So I stopped doing that. Like you said, it's never over. Yeah. So I realized that, you know, the thing that comes from in this is her painting the R as the machine. So that's it for me. I don't know.
that's an interesting point actually, which also I put to the ladies as well, so is how much do you rely on a non-artist's opinion of a work in progress for you to make that decision? Do you just say, okay, I know what you're saying, but that's not what I want to do, this is what I want to do, or actually yes, you're right, maybe I should try that. How much of an external opinion influences you walk away from it? He said this and she said that, and that. Oh, well, I guess that's the way of art, I guess. Before I throw the floor open to any questions that anybody might want to ask, I'd like to introduce our last artist for the evening. A very, very special person who, yes, is not present here with us because of her condition, I guess. Her name is Girija Srinivas, and she paints, you know, these very, very she paints Ganeshas, and her art is very naive art. I would urge you to seek out Girija Srinivas on the net. look at her work, and in spite of the condition that she is in physically as well, she manages to create something which is so expressive, which is absolutely fantastic. So it's been a very short and sweet evening. There's some fantastic art on display over here. I urge everybody present to take a closer look at it as well also. And if there are any questions from the audience, feel free to ask any questions right now to any of our present people over here. Other than friends I know, so yes.
Most of the work is commission.
Commission.
So she already has a subject.
She has a brief.
But what's like that? This one. I don't know, it came out of nowhere. Actually, it was a lighthouse somewhere, and I don't know where the church thing came from.
Okay.
But she told me there's a lighthouse somewhere, and I tried to capture the sunset. It was, I don't know, she goes up on trips. So whenever she comes back, she has a few images in her head. And that is one of them actually. So I guess she comes back from trips with all these images and then she works on it. I think so.
She's a traveler at heart, from her travels is what she brings into her heart. Rahul, tell us, what made Pooja choose pop art as an expression of her artistic?
I don't know, she's into too much pop culture. Actually, a bit apart from the question,
she gets bored by her paintings after a week. After a week of looking at paintings, I'm going to this. I don't know if that happens to you. This is done, I'm bored of it. What was the question?
What made her choose pop culture as?
As I said, she's very colorful. She's into lots of stuff. And, she travels, she reads, she swims, she cycles, she treks, I don't know, like lots of stuff. So, I think all of this mixes together and comes out in pop culture. And of course, all these. I love them. I asked for a Marilyn Manson, she made me Marilyn Monroe. She said, this is your Marilyn.
Give me the real thing.
So, I think she gets it from her very interest. And at heart, I think she's still stuck when you're here. So, all this.
I think as an artist, we always need to be in a place which is very childlike, which is what allows us to create. Okay, we're currently closing this sort of discussion right now. To end with, since Pooja is the young artist over here, senior ladies, any words of advice to, not to Pooja, but to artists who want to start out expressing themselves through painting, through various mediums, anything that you'd like to say to them from experiences?